Hello guys, welcome back to the new video. So today we install the RabbitMQ server on the Amazon EC2 instance. So by on this example, you can also do for your server hosting, any server you want. So let's get started. So before we can do, just go here and launch the instance. So let's select the Linux 2 AMI. T2 micro instance, leave the default, give it the name RabbitMQ server. Next, for the security group, let's create the additional rule here, TCP 1883 and 15675, and then give it to on IP address. So the port here will be the MQTT, and the port 15675 will be the MQTT over web socket. You want to refer to the ports wiki page here for detail. So you can see the 1883 will be the MQTTs, and then 15675 will be the MQTT over WebSocket. So basically the difference will be the you can connect to 1883 from the Java, for example, using the TCP, and this part basically you can connect from the web browser. Okay, so let's go next, launch the instance, acknowledge that we have the key in my local computer. So let's wait a moment until it completed. So the status now will be dependent. So let's wait few seconds. I guess it will not take more than 15 seconds. Still pending. Okay, here we go. So from here, you can guess the public IP, and then using the PuTTY. So I'm on Windows, I'm using PuTTY. So if you are on the Linux or Mac, just you do the SSH command, put IP here, and then connect. Yes, login at EC2 user. So from the AWS wiki page, it have the Docker guideline here to install the Docker on the EC2. First, you need to install the Docker. Let's run the OS update. And then after OS update, you need to install the Docker library here. Install the Docker, and after that you can do the Docker stock image. So basically you run this command to start the Docker service, and then we will run the user permission to the Docker. Okay, then what we need to do will be the log back again. Copy the IP again. Open EC2 user. Okay, so next will be create the Docker image. You can create a Docker image here. Okay, so let's create the Docker image file. So you go to the RabbitMQ Docker image here, And then basically what we need to do will be the enable the plugin. Copy this one. Press I to enable the insert mode. Okay, what we need to modify will be the plugin here. RabbitMQTT, RabbitMQ Web MQTT. Okay, and then what we need to do will be expo the port. Expo the port 15615. Okay, save and then quit. Next we need to do will be the run file, run the Docker image. Okay, run, let's run. So you will rename the RabbitMQ here into the your before you can run sorry before you can run we have to build Docker build, give it the name at my RabbitMQ and then build current file. And let me pull a video. Okay, done. So now we can run this one, run this command to run the Docker image. So you type in the image, either my RabbitMQ, and then we need to give some port number. So we will publish the port, this port 15678. So basically it will be forward the port from the internal Docker container into the Docker host, and then it will be available port on the EC2 instance. That's right. Docker container list. So we'll see the RabbitMQ up and running here. Okay, let's try to connect to check whether it is able to connect. Sorry, I clicked wrong tool. Let's run the power tool here. The power tool will be the tool for the MQTT client. So let's run with the IP address. Okay, connect. Here we go. So we able to connect. Let's try to subscribe for the topic. Okay, now you will publish the message on the test. Let's say empty message public, and then you able to receive it. Okay, that's it today. So the improvement will be, I leave the improvement to you, will be enable authentication. So that you can use the option here to log in, enable login with the username and password, as well as the enable the SSL for the MQTT server. The last one for improvement will be auto start the Docker, auto start the Docker and also the Docker container when the server starts. Okay, goodbye guys.